Top 5. Top 5.
The top 5. What's hot on the crossover?
Top 5.
Places, phrases, celebrities, clothes, streets, hoods. Represent.
Oh, you already know what we gonna do.
Top 5.
Yeah, you heard right. It's the top 5-5. The top 5-5. The top 5-5. Hi.
Hello.
How are you? I don't even know if I should introduce you. I mean, do I have the right to introduce you?
I'd love to hear you try. That'd be a lot of fun.
No, I'm not going to do it. Should I do it? Hi, Onechi.
How are you, sweetie?
I'm good. How are you?
Oh, I'm strong.
Long time no see.
Oh, yes, it has
you
been.
You have, like, disappeared off the face. Oh. My physical earth. I see you in my virtual world. I don't see you.
And in spirit, I'm never gone. It's always good to be back at the university. And I love it out here. You guys are so nice.
I'm super nice. I don't know about everyone else, but I'm really nice.
It's a great honor. Great honor.
So we have Onechi Luengo. Tell me if I say your surname right.
Luenje
in the studio. Yes, Mr. I can do everything. Yeah. So tell me, Onechi, what have you been up to?
Well, for those who aren't aware, Onechi is an author, an actor, and an upcoming filmmaker. So I've been developing a film project, and which it ties into really what my main message is about film and where our industry is now in Zambia. It's all about the essential nature of stories. And I think that's the main ingredient missing in film. So we're trying to bring that element of story, and beyond the special effects, beyond the technical, you know, the camera you're using, whatever, we want to bring in stories, and I want to bring that back. And then also, I am a poet, and I'm a big fan of Zambian poetry.
Yay.
And but I feel that we've reached a stalemate, and I believe that I have envisioned the future of the literary form, and I'm pursuing it passionately and look forward to sharing it with everybody.
So you're writing a book?
Yes.
Okay. I know people take years and years and years to write books. So how long have you been writing?
Well,
this particular one.
This particular project, it's a compilation of stories that I've been putting together since 2005.
Okay.
Was that? That's 7 years? Yeah.
Yeah. So what are your stories about? What goes on through Onechi's mind when he's writing?
Well, my primary focus is the human condition and the coming together as one of all people. And I like to remind people of our commonality, and to encourage people to forget our differences, and we should focus on what brings us all together. After all, we all have red blood living on a blue planet. Unconditional love is the seed of creativity that will heal our lovely home, Earth. Beyond the romance of simple idealism resides in all our hearts the steely resolve to make the right choices for love, for positivity, and for all.
There you go. You're so well spoken and scary. you're making me feel like, what am I going to say next?
Because it's all for love. And all the listeners, I love everybody.
So tell me about your top 5.
Well, I think this is going to be an interesting journey, because these songs have specific meaning to me, and I look forward to sharing them with you as we go through it.
But, okay.
Yeah, everything has a meaning, everything has a message.
It's true.
And we're all interconnected.
It's true. So what's the first song?
Well, I just need to make a note that I listen to everything. Listen to everything. If it's made by a human being, I listen to it. But the first song is it's called Thinking About You, and it's on Calvin Harris's recent album.
Okay. Shall I get on with it and play the song?
Thank you.
Thinking About You, Calvin Harris, featuring Ayama. Cool name.
It is, isn't it?
That's a cool name. Talk to me about Thinking About You.
Okay. You know, apart from being a very catchy, awesome song, which I play in the car all the time, when that song makes me think about duality, yin and yang. The entire universe resounds in tremendous approval when we make the decision to focus our energy on the positive, our spiritual nature, and interconnectedness. For duality is the test of all our existence. And, you know, duality, dark and light, left and right, the desire to chill with your homies when you know it's time to study. Okay? The distractive thoughts that disturb your quiet time of meditation. It is the man who has true self-mastery that transcends the trappings of the physical, carnal, and temporal. So the question becomes, will you make a stand? Shall we rise and write our story, our legacy?
Okay. Good one. You're making me think. I don't want to think.
Oh. Our society wants us to always to believe and to take orders, but we need to all start thinking and question everything.
I don't want to think right now.
Okay. You can have 5 minutes off, but then afterwards you have to think.
Okay. So let me get on with the top five and play the next song.
This one is Remedy featuring Craig David, and it's called Do It On My Own.
Yeah.
Crazy, that's all over.
Mr. Craig David and
Remedy.
Remedy. Do it on my own. I was actually saying just now you're into this whole electro pop. Douche, 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 douche.
I'll tell you what, a clever man once said, if you make friends with yourself, you will never be alone. So the question I want to pose is, do you have the gusto to go against the crowd and develop yourself? You know, all the people we strive to impress are all walking a separate individual journey.
True.
For life's experiences on this planet are only common physically. We only share a physical space, but mentally we're all doing our own thing.
Yeah.
So the task is to develop your mind, take your stand, become yourself.
So how do you become yourself in a world that gives us a particular image of what's beautiful, what's good, what art is, what this is and what that is? You know, I think it's very hard, especially for children who are coming up, to find their own identity with all these things that they're bombarded by.
It's very, very, very true. And the decision to want to better ourselves resides in all of us. And once you make that choice and you make that decision and that realization and you have that spark of inspiration, then the universe will respond and everything will fall into place. One of my favorite sayings is that when the student is ready, the master shall appear.
Okay. Okay.
So you just have to make that resolve inside yourself to want to do it. And then everything will fall into place. We will all be here to help you.
Tell me, what's the one thing that sets you apart from everyone?
Oh.
Just one.
Oh,
just
gosh.
One. Just one.
I
just
don't
one.
Think like that.
I don't want you to give me a list. I know you're unique, but just one. Just one thing. That makes, I don't want to say better, but yeah, that sets you apart.
Okay, I'll give you a double entendre.
Okay.
I focus on how all of us as people, every race, every creed, every religion, every walk of life, we're all the same. And we are simply one organism. We are humankind. I don't focus on what divides us, national lines, religions. I focus on what brings us together, our commonality,
love,
our humanity,
love,
and unconditional love. That's right.
Yes, I knew. I just had to put that in somewhere, because obviously I'm going to ask you a question, but you know, I mean, I'm just not going to ask you now.
Okay.
Yeah. So next up on the top five.
Next song is,
of course,
History.
Of course,
by the master
this
Michael Jackson.
Wouldn't even miss. The way you're obsessed with Michael Jackson, it's like so disturbing.
love, unconditional love is a wonderful thing.
Play it.
We'll be right back. December 5th, 1901.
December 7th, 1903.
The top five. What's hot on the crossover?
Top five.
Places, phrases, celebrities, yeah. Clothes, streets, hoods. Mwah! Represent.
Oh, you already know what we gonna do.
Top five.
Hey. Well, would you look at this? Look at this. I am actually tempted to, you know, give away a little secret of what happened just now in the studio, but I don't know. How much are you going to pay me to keep my mouth shut?
Gosh, oh my gosh. if the listeners are psychic, they will already figure it out.
How much are you going to pay me to keep this quiet?
I have a feeling you're going to tell them anyway, so.
I won't, if you pay me. History. It's very, very much in line with everything that you've just said.
Absolutely. And in addition to me liking, you know, Michael's ballads, as in his gospel songs. Everybody likes knows the fast stuff, but, like, you know, Will You Be There, Cry, and History, very nice, great gospel songs. And in addition to that, of course, you know, the message again. Do we know from whence we came? Do we have a true understanding of where we're going? It's the importance of legacy. And I don't think we talk about that enough, you know? Like, what's the heading on your tombstone going to read? And more importantly, what impact will you have on the people that you had the opportunity to come into contact with in your life? What's your legacy, History?
Goddess. That's my legacy. Goddess.
And I think, yeah.
Bow down before me.
Well, now, honey.
Yeah, goddess. Hi, stranger. No, I can't hear you.
Looks like somebody's come to crash the party.
You still can't hear me.
I can hear you now.
Are you sure?
Yes.
I can hear myself.
It's okay. It's okay, even if you can hear yourself, it doesn't matter. We don't like you anymore.
Really?
Yeah, so moving on. Mm-hmm. Number four. Wow, number four? Really?
This song is called Death Is Only a Door. It's from the score, the soundtrack album of the latest film by Tom Twicker and Lana and Andy Wachowski called Cloud Atlas.
You know, I was actually expecting something from the Transformers to be on your top five. I mean, I'm just saying, I know you're a fan, so yeah, I was just expecting
I got it. We have another blockbuster coming up, so you have to wait for that one. Another blockbuster.
I'm waiting.
Thank you.
Top five. Five. Top five.
The top five. What's hot on the crossover?
Top five. Five.
Places, phrases, celebrities, yeah. Clothes, streets, hoods. Represent.
Oh, you already know what we gonna do.
Top five. Five.
I like it. It's really cool. It's
yeah.
Cool. It's so cool.
Death is merely a transition, a retiring of the physical form to coalesce your spiritual progress. Greater glories await that you cannot conceive. Understand your tripartite nature as a person. As a spiritual entity having a human experience, you are physical, mental, and astral. And all of this, it's all a remembering.
Cool. I want the remembering even me. Now I'm just being silly. So I know you talked about being an actor and doing movies. Tell me a bit about what you've done before we go to the next song.
Okay, sure. I've been performing since I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
School plays, high school productions, we won awards, did a little touring with some productions. I've done TV commercials, I've done extra work on some of Zambia's biggest shows.
Okay.
I've done some films which haven't been released, and to the filmmakers, hi, release the films.
Yes, please release the films.
Yeah. But I love media is my first love. Art, I love art, all forms of art.
Yeah. Awesome. So we're moving on to the last song in the top five. This has been like a really, really mellow top five. So, okay.
This
Hans Zimmer.
Yes, this is Bombers Over Ibiza, the Junkie XL remix from the soundtrack of the best movie, in my opinion, of 2012, The Dark Knight Rises. No, it's Twilight. I'm sorry. I love all the Twilight fans.
That's just not me booing you. It's like a bunch of us. So it's not really coming out loud.
I'm sure they all love Twilight and love them too.
There you go.
Thank you.
Bombers over Ibiza.
Hi. Yeah, hey. Too much segregation going on here, so.
You know, yeah. there's a phrase that's repeated in that song, which is Deshi Basara, which is, according to the filmmakers, is Moroccan and means rise.
Mm-hmm.
So when I listen to that song, what comes to my mind is the transition of the ages, December 2012. Now, a lot has been said about December 2012, you know, but of all the things that it potentially represents, at the end of it, we as humanity, as mankind, determine how it will all work out.
True.
Our collective superconscious or our hive mind. Here we have an opportunity to say, poverty, your expiration date is come. War, all forms of deprivation of the human condition for the sole benefit of a select elite. Such notions will no longer be viable beyond this point because it's time for people to have an opportunity for positive progress. And this time, nothing is standing in the way and we're taking charge to succeed. We have that opportunity to make a stand. And going into that, myself and some other people we've created a Facebook page called Brotherhood for Humanity.
Mm-hmm.
It's facebook.com/Brotherhood for Humanity and my own Facebook. And pretty much we're designing an event on the 20th of December 2012 where we are going to post a positive affirmation.
Yeah.
And we're going to ask everybody out there to read that affirmation at a specific time, and want everybody around the world to do it at the same time. We're going to read out this affirmation and just simply repeat it a few times. It won't take more than 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to enter, because the 21st of December is the winter solstice. So we want to enter this new era, this new phase, on a very, very positive note, because it's our mandate, it's our job, and this is why we are here today, to rebuild our world and to make Earth a haven of joy and goodness and love for all. And so I would ask everybody to jump on to Facebook and to like the Brotherhood for Humanity page, and together we can do this, make our stand, let our voices be heard.
Yeah.
This time we will succeed, and we can only succeed if we do it together.
Just, you know, listening with the background music sounds really it sounds like the end of the movie and everybody's leaving now.
But let us not forget.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not forget what's been said, and let's put, if you go away with anything, at least go away with this one thought in your subconscious mind, which is a pluribus unum, which means together as one. And it's only through our commonality and our coming together, our unity, we be able to transcend all the things that have kept us all apart. And then we can all come together and make the world a better place.
Awesome, 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 awesome. All throughout the time that you guys have been talking and, you know, doing the music, I have been struggling going through the web, trying to find that movie that looks almost like Atlantis. Finally found it. The Golden Compass.
Oh, I haven't seen it. I didn't see it.
Is it similar to Cloud Atlantis?
Well, it beat Transformers 1 for the Oscar. Special effects. I was furious, so I didn't watch it. But I probably will after this conversation. I'll go rent it from Blockbuster.
Okay.
I can find one, yeah.
Okay, cool. It's been great having you, obviously. Very deep.
Ask him an uncomfortable question.
Such you want me to ask him an uncomfortable question?
Yes. I've been very nice today. I've been the nice.
Well, this is the top five. Have we reached the random question of the day already?
Mm-hmm.
Serious?
It's 11.
It's 11 already. Eh?
Yeah.
Okay, you know the random question of the day?
What's the question? I hope I know the answer.
Let's play him a jingle. Can we play him a jingle? And then he gets an idea what the random question of the day is. Sorry, guys, I'm late today. But I'm sure Martha took it by the horns and.
No.
What, she took it by the tail?
She took it by the bone.
There you go. Listen to this. Listen to this, Onechi.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, random questions of the day.
What's your shoe size?
You're with Bungie, right?
When was the last time you paid for your own meal?
Do you know the president of Croatia?
What's the first phone that you used?
Ever had a one night stand?
How many boyfriends have you had?
Do you drink?
How many girlfriends have you had?
Do you smoke?
How many girls are you dating right now?
What's your favorite chill out point?
How much do you have in your wallet?
How many Facebook accounts do you have? Really?
Do you know your NRC number? Random questions all day.
Call us up on 0211-29-3435. Ask us or we ask you the questions. Random questions all of the day. 0211-29-3435.
That's the random question of the day. And so we're gonna start from this. Do you look all dressed up? Did you run away from work?
Oh my god, are you serious? Are you
serious? Go ahead.
Oh my god, I didn't run.
Mm-hmm.
But I love all my current and previous co-workers. I love you all.
I guess that answers
it. I just dress like this every day.
Okay. If you were to choose, you know, of all your favorite movies, of all the movies that you've watched, Oh, which boy.
Which one would be your favorite?
Ooh. That's a hard one.
Let's make it even harder. You're in a house, you've got all your movie collection, the house is on fire, and you're only allowed to pick out one movie from the collection. Which one would you pick out?
Oh, gosh. Can I pick three? I would definitely grab my Dark Knight DVDs, mm-hmm. my Transformers, and my Matrix Special Edition 10 disc deluxe edition box set. I'd grab those. Okay. The rest can be downloaded. I'm from Amazon and from hmv.co.uk.
Yeah, okay, interesting. Okay, now with do you enjoy Michael Jackson's
music? Yeah, I know, yes. That's a fact. I've seen you dance to Michael Jackson.
Yes.
You know,
I've never seen that before.
I have a video.
Really?
He doesn't know that I have a video.
Oh my.
This is a, you know what? When you take videos or you allow friends to take videos of you,
my God.
They travel.
I want to see that video.
Me too.
You want to see the video?
I want to see the video.
Okay.
That was a good song.
Okay, interesting. Now, you know, how does it feel whenever you do the Michael Jackson impersonification?
It's interesting because there's something about those moves that makes people happy. I really don't think I'm that great. Mm-hmm. But whenever anywhere in the world you see people mimicking and imitating the steps, mm-hmm. it just brings so much joy and happiness. I think that's a testament to the longevity and to the greatness of the performer. Mm-hmm. And there's one thing which I learned from Jackson's artistry, which is, it's one thing he said, whenever I create, I always bind my soul to my work. And so, and I've taken that on myself, and anything I create, anything I write, anything I do, mm-hmm. I just try, I put it all on the table, and I really just, so if ever one was to look back to it, mm-hmm. that would be my mind and my spiritual condition in that moment. Yeah.
Okay, interesting. Chef, any random question for him?
She wolf.
No, I'm good.
You wanna know his shoes?
Oh my God.
I'm good today. I'm the nice one today.
Doesn't it? Oh gosh.
I'm the nice one today.
So you want me to be mean?
Yeah. That's your job today.
Okay. Well, you know, you never leave this place without answering an uncomfortable question.
Okay. I don't know what's more uncomfortable about somebody having a video of me dancing like Michael Jackson. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Like my collar is dripping with sweat now.
No, if this was TV, it would probably make you dance.
Oh boy.
To the song. Thank God it's not.
Yeah.
Thank
okay,
God.
So uncomfortable question, would you? Do you go out a lot? Do you go out as much? Be in cinema, maybe club.
I love to interact with people. I like to feel energy. I like to be around positive energy. So, yeah, I like energy.
Okay.
Positive energy.
What would be the wildest thing you have done in a cinema?
Take my shoes off and my socks and put my feet up.
Oh, gosh.
It's the most outrageous thing I've ever done.
Okay. I guess I think, well, let's call it the wrap, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there
he's
full.
Feeling shy to ask you questions. He's feeling shy.
I don't know.
He's feeling shy.
Yeah, you might just come and then say, I'll never come again on the show, you know. He's a man of many talents, so I, you know, poetry, you know, whatnot. Fume, dance, you know. He's a man of many talents.
But you guys can always inbox me on Facebook or any of your questions you want answered. And mm-hmm. If you keep checking back on my YouTube channel,
mm-hmm.
you might just see a clip of me dancing. I might get to Ghana's clip.
Okay, what's your YouTube channel? What's the name?
It's my first name, Onechi, youtube.com/Onechi.
Okay.
You can just search me when you're in YouTube as well.
Okay, cool.
I shall search for you.
She's actually doing it.
Oh, she's doing it now?
Yeah.
Good
no,
bandwidth.
I'm not.
Okay.
No, I'm not.
Okay, cool. So, rundown of the top five songs again. Just, you know, from the top, the first one to the last one, as, you know, we go into the next season.
Do you want to do it?
I would love to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Number five, because it was in reverse, right? Number five was Thinking About You by Calvin Harris. Number four was Do It On My Own by Remedy featuring Craig David. Number three was History by the great Michael Jackson. Number four was Death Is Only a Door, from the score of the Hollywood film Cloud Atlas. And finally, number one was Bombers Over Ibiza, Junkie XL remix by the phenomenal Hans Zimmer.
Mm-hmm. Zig Zimmer
and his crew.
Zig Zimmer, you know, I call him Zig Zimmer, one of the greatest score producers. I don't know what you is it called, you know,
score creators, mm-hmm. The Lion King, great
yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
So, to all the listeners, I wish you peace, love, joy, and unconditional love and happiness. It's your portion, so receive it. I want to say hi to my mom. I love you, mom. And to my friend Blanket. Hi.
That's a funny name.
Mm-hmm. Blanket, huh? Okay, I see where this is going. I see where that is going. Thank you so much for coming, Onechi.
And more importantly, a special shout out to all the disenfranchised, sick and dying youth. I feel your pain, and together we will heal this world. I send you all my love.
Isn't he sweet?
Yeah, philosophical.
Isn't he sweet?
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you so much for coming, Onechi.
It's been a great honor. I had so much fun, as usual.
So
look forward to coming again soon.
For those movie directors and producers to release the movie.
Release the film.
Yeah, we're waiting. You know, just so you know, we're waiting patiently.
As soon as they do, I'll come back and I'll let you know.
Okay, thanks. Yay. Thank you so much to Onechi for gracing our top five.